I will start with personal advice about our comfort zone, about our limits. Let me tell you that all balls are possible to defend. Yes, we have to have in mind that we can defend all balls. Okay, you know that defense isn't about making points, and sometimes we are not paying much attention to our defense. But if you want to play good volleyball, you can play it without good defense. So I have for you essential advice how to play defense. All balls are possible to defend. When we play volleyball, we have some limits. Some limits are clear, and we can change them. It's impossible to attack a high ball from 5 meters out of the net and try to hit it into a sharp diagonal to a 3 meter line. It's just not possible. It's just about physics. And then there are limits that we set ourselves, a soft limits that can be changed. We often think it's impossible to play some ball, that it's impossible to defend that ball, it's impossible to defend a powerful attack from Wilfredo Leon. I had the same limits when I saw the ball falling 5 meters away from me. I said to myself, I can take this ball. I never took it. So in the end, I decided even not to try to take it. I just stopped my movement for the ball and I sacrificed that ball. Sometimes I even said to myself, this ball is not essential. We are leading by 8 points, so if I don't take it, nothing will happen. But I was many times mistaken. My limits were not where I set them in my head. Julio Velasco showed me that even a ball that was in my eyes lost can be defended. So don't think about the balls, try to defend them. Do your best. If you try to defend every ball, you find out that your personal limits are not about what you think, but what you do. And I can tell you that most of us are underestimating our potential. So again, never assume that some kind of balls is undefeatable. Try to defend it, and then you can say, it was tough to defend it. I didn't make it. But with every attempt, you will push your limits, and one day you will defend an amazing ball that will be decisive for your team victory. Some balls can fall to the ground. Yes, we know that we are losing point if the ball falls on our side of the court. We don't want to lose, so we are trying to defend and play incoming balls. Some balls are tough to defend. We have to run, jump, or make a great defense to touch these balls. On the other hand, there are many situations when our opponent is forced to play easy ball to our side. We make great serve, setter can't set the ball, so they pass the ball to our side. And even at this easy situation, we can make a mistake and the ball can fall to the ground. Even the best teams in the world are sometimes struggling with these easy balls. It's a lot about communication. We know that first ball is not for setter. Spiker or libero in ideal situations should take it. We also know that we should call I, me or mine when the ball is coming close to us. But there are situations when we don't communicate and we lose the point. Coach is angry, we are not happy, we are watching each other. Some players are searching for excuses, some players are blaming others. Anyway, we lost a point. It was an easy ball for us. We should pass the ball perfectly to the setter. The setter should set fast set to middle blocker or spiker. That ball should be our point. And again, these situations can happen in the beginning of the game, so they are not important in our eyes. But when they occur in the end of the sets, we are all unhappy. So don't underestimate any ball. Every simple ball is important, and we need to defend it or pass it to the setter with total concentration. Of course, we need to communicate about these easy balls. Defense is organized based on what the attacker does and how the block is prepared. It's not easy to play well in defense. It's not easy from a player view, and of course not easy from a team view. There are so many possibilities, so many situations. We can expect fast attacks from middle blockers, attacks from outside hitters and opposites, pipes, combinations, and we have very few time to react. When we want to be successful in defense, we can think only about one option, one strategy for defending that particular attack. We have to adapt to actual conditions. One time we are defending quick attack from the position 4 against single block. Next time our middle blocker is there to help setter against this quick attack from position 4. So we in defense can't wait in the same place. We have to watch what is attacker doing, what kind of attacks is coming. We need to take in consideration our block. Is there a single block or double block? Is the set close to the net or 2 meters out of the net? These are the questions we need to answer to ourselves. So when you are defending, don't think about stereotype. Think about possible attacks that may come and be ready for all of them. It's important to decide what we prefer. When I say that we can defend any ball, I mean it. On the other hand, we can't expect to defend every single ball. The attacker has an advantage. He can choose where he will attack. He can attack line, diagonal, make a tip or power tip. And against single block, his advantage is quite significant. So we need to think about our possibilities. If I see opposite attacking again single block, will I go for a tip? If I see middle blocker attacking quick set, will I stay on 9 meter line? No, if I do this, I will not defend the ball. So it's about our personal decision and our team decision. It's about our tactics, about knowledge of our opponents, it's about our potential. Some players are great in defense, some could be better. So when you want to defend the ball, think about your situations and position where you have higher chances of defending the ball. We must divide the space in defense. This is essential advice. When you see top volleyball teams and their defense system, it's like a symphony. Team and each player are doing their work. They know precisely how to deal with any situation. They understand that some attacks were just great and they forget about that spike to 3 meter line. Each player has its role in defense. But when we play defense, we can play like hungry dogs chasing chicken. We can't run all to pass that easy ball. We can stand three players on the line expecting hard attack from opposite. We need a system. We need to know about each player. You need to know what ball is yours and which balls are not yours. We need to know how to react in different situations, just like top teams. So even if you play regional competition, divide the space, set up responsibilities of each player and then practice and practice. Defense is one of the skills that it's not visible, like attack, block or serve. But if you play great in defense, you can expect a good chance to make more points in attack and your opponent won't be happy to play against you and your defense system. I have to be under the ball and have the ball in front of me. Until now I was speaking about advice how to think about defense. I can skip the skill part. If you want to play good defense, you need to be ready for incoming balls. You need to be in good power position to be able to make fast movements to defend hard attacks. You need to be ready for block touches and ball flying away from you. You need to be prepared for tips. In all these situations, the ball has to be in front of you. Once the ball is behind you, your chances to defend that ball are almost zero. Also, we are much faster when we move forward, we are slow when we move backward. So when there is a triple block, don't go for a tip to 3 meter line. Just wait for a tip and then move forward. One more thing is crucial in defense. When you defend a powerful attack, you need to play it high in the middle of the court. And for this to achieve, you need to be under the ball. You can expect to defend a well hard attack if you are standing on your outstretched legs. So stay in lower power position and try to defend the ball high. This way you will give your setter time to get under the ball and set high ball for spiker. A good defense system leaves a free zone where fewer balls go. It's not the one which wants to defend everything. Imagine you are playing against Brazil. They are Olympic winners, so they are one of the best teams in the world. They have so many options and weapon how to attack and score a point. Do you think that you can defend all their attacks? I don't think so, since they are outstanding and even other top teams cannot stop or defend all their attacks. But this was just an example, so even when you play against a team on the same level as yours, don't try to defend every ball, don't try to cover every inch on the court. Focus on areas and positions where is the higher chance for incoming attacks. I hope this advice how to think and play defense will help you to become a better player or a coach. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.